again. Trying hard, but you wanna be my friend. Well, hey everybody, welcome back to My View on the View, a commentary podcast all about ABC's The View. I'm so glad that you are back with me. I hope that you're having a fantastic day. This is My View on the View, as you heard, a commentary podcast all about ABC's The View. I make The View's table relatable to our everyday lives. Now listen, check the description box if you have any questions about me, the music, what you're seeing there on your screen, anything. Today's episode of the podcast is sponsored by Audible. If you like a free 30-day trial of Audible, any book, as many books as you want, free for 30 days, check out my link in the description box, okay? Well, guys, I knew this was going to happen. I knew this was going to happen, and it has happened. Alyssa Farah has once again gotten on the wrong side of viewers, and I will tell you, I've been saying this for a while now. I'm going to keep speaking what I think is the truth here. Listen, I don't think it's going to stop here. You say, what are you talking about? Well, if you missed Monday's show, Monday, July 11th, which was yesterday, when the women came back from, you know, their break, they had been in the Bahamas for a week, then they took a week off, and then they came back to us on Monday, excluding Joy and Sarah. If you saw the show, you know that Alyssa and Anna had two kind of difficult exchanges. One of them was really difficult, and Whoopi had to interject and throw it to commercial. Now, let's listen together, for those of you especially who didn't hear it or see the show. Let's listen to both of those interactions, and I'm going to come back, and I'm going to tell you what fans are saying, and I'm also going to give you my view on The View.
Boris Johnson resigned for far less. He basically resigned for partying, for having parties. But the reason he resigned is because members of his own party, members of his own cabinet, members of his own administration, people with cojones resigned and forced him to resign.
Yes. Right.
So all of these Republicans now testifying, the Bill Barrs and all of these people who were complicit, apologists, who enabled him, who justified him, who defended him for 4 years, the very least they can come and do now is say the truth.
Yeah. And I agree with that, but I want to say one thing though, because we are we're facing a potential Trump presidency ahead of us. He could win again, and those are terrifying words, by the way, to say. And I hope if that happens, Cassidy Hutchinson's go into the White House. I hope that people who are willing to do the right thing, to tell the truth, go in, because I'm telling you,
and if work
it's staffed,
with Trump again?
I'm just telling you, if it's staffed entirely by Bannon,
our country
will
fail. He didn't tell the truth. You all didn't say the truth for 4 years.
Here's the deal.
And so,
here's
you know, it's
deal.
When he
if
lost
he wins
power
again,
that the truth all of a sudden became a thing.
January 6th, which we talk about a lot, showed political violence happening in our country. I was working for members of the Freedom Caucus when the congressional shooting took place, and it was bosses of mine who were targeted years ago. I want to make sure that as we are protesting, these, having these fundamental American conversations about what we want our country to be and who we should be, that we just make sure we're keeping the temperature down. It doesn't turn into harassment or intimidation, which this obviously
didn't.
Well,
the Freedom Caucus in particular, I think, sort of injected some of that right-wing extremism into
our
country's
politics. Well, and I've talked about that. I've talked about that extensively, especially the direction they've gone in the Trump years is not something I recognize or would have put my name to. But I agree.
It is surprising to me that you actually worked with Jim Jordan, who I think, in many respects, and Mark Meadows, sort of lit this flame that we're seeing in our country.
I think that they do hold a significant amount of responsibility. The thing is years ago, their focus was on budget, securing the border, bringing down the deficit. It was not this vast
right. You mean when Republicans were Republicans?
It was not this vast right wing
Freedom Caucus has been a thorn on the side of people like Paul Ryan and John Boehner. And
well, you criticize Paul Ryan all the time for his role at Fox.
I know Paul Ryan. Well, I can criticize him because he's my friend. And the Paul Ryan I know.
I'm going to take a break right now. We go on the break.
Yeah. And as you heard, and as I said before, you know, Whoopi had to throw it to commercial. She had to get louder to be able to be heard over top of Anna. Really, I will tell you that when Alyssa, you know, said what she said about Paul Ryan there, Anna snapped back really quickly. So what fans are saying is this, is that they don't like Alyssa Farah because she is going after one of the viewers' favorites, one of their favorites, which is Anna Navarro. In case you don't know, Anna Navarro is one of the most popular hosts in The View's 25-year history. She is extremely popular.
Now, being extremely popular doesn't mean that every single person likes you. It just means the majority of people do, and that they think that you have something valuable to add to the table, which she does. All right? That's why they had to bring her on. So to poke at, as I said yesterday, or to try to challenge one of the viewers' favorites is just going to always get on the bad side of viewers. And I would think that she would know that. So here's what I want to say. We all know that this show is not categorized as a news program. You know, I think a lot of people think it is because of what they talk about. But if you search for The View anywhere, you will find it always in the entertainment category. If you look on their YouTube page, you know, any YouTuber's page, really, you can see the category that they have chosen for their podcast, their video, their YouTube channel. If you search for The View's podcast anywhere on Stitcher, Apple, Spotify, you will always find it not in the news category, but in the entertainment category, because the show is a group of women who represent the women in America who are sitting there giving their personal opinion on what's happening in the news, but they're not there to report the news. That's really two different things, okay? No person, in my view on The View, should turn to The View to get their news. I mean, that's not what we're supposed to do, again, in my view. So having said that, I think we do need to understand that The View is looking for entertainment here. And so if they see a strong reaction from viewers regarding the dynamic between Alyssa Farah and Anna Navarro, who are both two Republicans, let's not forget that, two Republicans, all right, they're going to play on that because it's entertaining. And nowadays, entertainment really means getting a strong emotional reaction from your listener, your viewer, your whatever. Now, we may not agree with that, but that is just the way that it is. That's why reality TV is so popular. That's why things like The Bachelor are so popular, because viewers, as they watch those type of shows, their emotions go up and down, up and down. They're crying one moment, they're laughing the next moment, they're oh the next moment, and oh the next moment, right? And so that's what this is designed. This is just the whole thing about entertainment. And so I will tell you, I was not surprised when fans had a real negative reaction to yesterday's show because, again, Anna is one of the fan favorites. And Alyssa, you know, has strikes against her. You know, she was in the White House, in the Trump administration, and she was not someone who came in not really knowing what was going on, you know, not really knowing what he was all about. She took a job. She, according to her, she left her dream job in the Department of I forgot the department, the prior department she worked for, but she left that, she said, was her dream job to take a job in the Trump administration, and he had been in office for 4 years. You think about all the things that had happened. He had been impeached at once, excuse me, he had been impeached once by that time. He had had, we were in COVID, right? And the mess that was made of that, all the lies, right? And then later the recording from Bob Woodward's conversation, excuse me, with him, where he literally told Bob, yes, this is more deadly than the flu, blah, blah, blah. And then just a few weeks later, he went out and just said, hey, it's a hoax. So there are so many things that all of us as Americans, and shout out to my international listeners, even our international listeners could name, had happened that were horrific by his fourth year in office, but, you know, she took a job there. So a lot of people still feel that, you know, that was just a really bad sign of what kind of person this was, right? And that a lot of these people didn't jump from the ship that was sinking until they literally had to. It was either preserve the little piece of reputation I have and try to keep a check coming, or stick with this guy, you know, knowing that he was not going to be elected again. So again, I wasn't surprised, guys, and probably you weren't either, that a lot of fans had a negative reaction when they saw her, you know, what fans interpreted as her poking at Anna, as her trying to challenge Anna. Again, that's a part of the entertainment value of this dynamic. But you have to remember, a lot of fans sometimes forget that it's entertainment. You know what I'm saying? So now, as I end our time together, let me just share my view on The View. I will say that for me, vlogging about the show really does help me stay pretty fair-minded, because I do have to remember that it is entertainment mostly, and that whatever dynamic, remember I even proposed to you guys last year that, you know, okay, Tara Settmayer, you know, had left the Republican Party, right? And she became, according to her, a registered independent. I played the clip of her saying that to you guys. And we haven't seen Anna and Tara at the table at the same time in the more recent months, okay? Not saying it hasn't ever happened. I'm speaking about, again, the more recent months. And so I said to you guys, that would be a perfect dynamic for the show to play off of. You have two Republicans who both call out the party, but one has stayed, that would be Anna, and one has left, that would be Tara. It would be an excellent dynamic to play off of, because the sparks would naturally be there. Why did you stay versus why did you leave? And I can't believe you're still there. And well, I can't believe you left. There's just so much that could come there and come from that. And Anna and Tara are both very sharp knives, right? And so that would just be dynamic. Well, we never saw them try to, at least up till this point of our conversation today, them try to play off that dynamic. But if they give the job to Alyssa Farah Griffin, which I personally, as I shared with you yesterday, after watching how confident she was and just the whole change in her tone of her behavioral tone, lets me know that she has gotten the job. And she hasn't said anything because it's their job to introduce her. But, you know, none of us can keep a secret, really. I mean, if we don't give it away verbally, our body language gives it away. Our attitude gives it away. A special look we have on our face gives it away, right? And so as human beings, it's very difficult for us to keep secrets. So I will just tell you guys, I wasn't surprised. And I'm sure you weren't either. Now let's talk about what we're going to, what could possibly come of this, all right? One thing that could happen is that Alyssa could unintentionally, or maybe intentionally, because self-sabotage is a real thing, paint herself into a corner where before she even gets a full season under her belt, folks are calling for her to be fired. Y'all know, when folks start calling for folks to be fired, you know, petitions get started, et cetera, right? So that could be what happens. If this is going to be something, meaning this dynamic between the two of them, if this is going to be something that fans see a whole lot, I can promise you they're going to choose Anna over Alyssa. And I'm sorry, so am I. I mean, I'm not going to lie to you about it. I would definitely prefer Anna than Alyssa, okay? And so most fans are going to go that route. And so one of the things that Alyssa Farah needs to be very careful with these interactions she's going to be having with Anna Navarro is that she doesn't paint herself in a corner. Another thing that could come of this is that, well, the two ladies could wind up really becoming the show, so to speak. Remember what became the show in season, was it 23? It was Joy Behar and Meghan McCain, because their dynamic almost took over the table. Right? Because it started off positive, then it became very negative, okay? To the point where the new ABC News president, Mrs. Kimberly Godwin, had to call a meeting and say, stop it. Stop the personal attacks. Remember, we learned about that from TMZ. If you weren't with us, check the description box. I have made sure to pin that podcast there where we went over that TMZ leak with a fine-tooth comb. So guys, those are my thoughts on what fans are thinking here. Let us know, when you saw the show yesterday, again, 7/11/22 show, what were your thoughts when you were watching the interaction between Alyssa Farah and Anna Navarro? Drop down in the comments and let us know. Thanks so much for joining me today, guys. I really enjoy talking with y'all about the show. Y'all are the only people I have to talk to about it. Nobody else can. Okay, I promise you, they really don't. So this is My View on The View, a commentary podcast all about ABC's The View. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up, to subscribe, to follow, to share. And of course, if you want a free 30-day trial of Audible, check out the link in the description box. Bye, guys.
go, here we go again. Trying hard, but you wanna be my friend. Ain't no place to hide.